Hey, this is Mike Gingerich with Life and Leadership Lesson Number 1. Going to try these out, quick little tidbits to give you something to reflect on for your own life, for your own leadership, to see that you are accomplishing all that you were intended to accomplish. So for me recently, I just finished running the PA Grand Canyon Half Marathon. Now, great accomplishment, great race, not because it was easy or because I was necessarily fast, okay? This was not my PR, personal record in this one. This one was satisfying because I'd done just enough preparation and training to finish well, decently, all right? And so what I wanna talk about is the life lesson number one is preparation matters. If you want to accomplish something, you're gonna have to put time in, you're gonna have to put effort in, you're gonna have to do the preparation to be good and ready for what you're doing, okay? So I had trouble on this one. Doesn't mean you're not gonna have trouble along the way. So I usually like to do a 12-week block of training for a half marathon, and I missed over 3.5 of those weeks with injuries during this block. So it was not great. As a matter of fact, my longest run was just the week before, and I only ran 7.5 miles. So I did a training to run a 13.1 mile race, and I missed over 3.5 weeks of that training, and the most I'd run was 7.5. So I was not sure what was gonna happen, but I learned I did just enough. My preparation mattered, and I did it. Number two was, the second thing I want to talk about is set realistic goals. So my goal was not to run 13.1 miles as fast as I could. It was to run 13.1 miles by finishing, and I broke it down even further than that. I wanted to run 9 miles at the race pace that I had set. So again, and that was not even trying to, I wanted to get to 9 miles at the pace that I felt like I should be able to do, and then I was gonna be okay with whatever happened, slow down, just finish the last 4 miles, okay? And so what I did was I set out and I ran well, and I ran on pace for that 6 mile, 7th mile, 8th mile, and I thought, okay, I can get to this 9. I got to the 9th mile, and I made it. And so I had set a realistic goal based on the preparation I had done, okay, and I accomplished that. But then my third point is we need to adapt along the way. So I had to adapt first in my training when I was going through those injuries. I had to rest, and now I had to adapt on the fly during the race, and what am I gonna do now that I've made it through 9? And I set a short-term goal. I said, I'm gonna try to hold this through 10, okay? And I tried to hold that pace through 10, and I did. I held that slightly under 9-minute mile pace through my 10th mile, okay? So that now I'm at 10, and it's 13.1, so I've got a 5K to go, 3.1 to go. I said, what am I gonna do now? I said, I'm gonna try to hold this out for 2 more miles, and then I know if I can get those 2 miles in, I can gut out the last 1.1 miles. So I locked onto someone, a gal that was just past me a little bit, and she was going just a touch faster than me, and I locked on her. I just followed her, okay? I was glued to her side along the way, and I didn't try to focus on anything other than my form. You know, I was just trying to keep my legs going, keep my arms pumping, raising my knees, straight form, good posture, digging in. And I made it to those 2 miles with her, and then I knew there's only 1.1 left, nothing's stopping me, let's finish this thing. And I did, and it was a great accomplishment. Definitely not my fastest half marathon to date, but maybe one of the most satisfying because of the injuries that I had overcome, the lack of training that I felt like I'd done, but the preparation that I tried to do, and then seeing it come together where I met all those goals. I met the 9-mile goal and the 10-mile goal, and then I met the finish line goal. So when you're thinking back on your life, I want you to think about this. You know, what are you trying to accomplish? What is it? What's the big goal for you in this, you know, next year, next 2 years, whatever that time period is? And are you doing the preparation? You gotta put in the preparation that matters on that. You gotta set a realistic goal. And the realistic goal needs to be based on, you know, the preparation time that you have to put in. What are you gonna dedicate to this along the way? And then be ready to adapt, tweak that goal along the way because circumstances change. You may accomplish it early, you may have setbacks, and you need to be able to adjust. That's okay. You can still reach the goal or a version of that goal based on that. So think through those things. What's helpful for your life, your leadership today? Hopefully that's helpful to get you thinking. Ponder that, all right? I really appreciate if you give me some feedback on these things. Is this worth my time? Life leadership moments, if it is, give me some comments. Just let me know that what you take away from this or what you thought of it, and that will help me with some good feedback. All right, I appreciate that. This is Mike, over and out. Take care.